Calendar number 1271 by Senator Serino, Senate Print 7052, enact amend the vehicle and traffic law.
Senator Latimer, why do you rise?
President, will the senator yield for a few questions?
Will the sponsor yield for a question?
Yes, I will, Mr.
Sponsor
President.
Sponsor yields.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, Senator. Senator, can you explain the nature of the fees that this bill intends to eliminate?
I can tell you that this bill eliminates the MTA licensing and registration fees that are imposed on the residents of Dutchess, Putnam, Orange, and Rockland counties.
Thank you. Would the senator continue to yield?
Senator, the sponsor yield?
Yes,
sponsor
Mr. President.
Yield.
Thank you, Senator. Are those fees, in addition to being paid by Dutchess County, Putnam County, Orange County, and Rockland County, are they also paid by residents of Nassau County?
I believe they are, but the makeup on the way this is determined for Dutchess, Rockland, Orange, and Putnam, they only have one quarter of a vote on the board for the MTA, totaling one vote, and that's not fair.
If the Senator would continue to yield to the President. Notwithstanding that the allocation of power on the MTA board favors some counties over others, the fee itself, is it not paid in the same percentage by residents in Nassau County and in other parts of the MTA payroll area, MTA service area?
Yes, and you know, I'll tell you about Dutchess County. We have approximately 300,000 people. 2% of our population utilizes Metro North on a weekly basis. So you have 98% of the people that are being penalized. And keep in mind, the 98% have vehicles that they are paying insurance on to go to work, school, and play. So then it's like a smack in the face every 2 years when they have to pay that $50 fee. And not just for their cars, for their trailers, you know, whether it be a recreational trailer or a trailer that somebody's going to work with, the landscaping trailer. It's been a level of frustration since 2009 when this was imposed by this body. So I've been involved in politics since 2010, so I've been hearing it for the past 6 years.
Would the senator continue to yield?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, Madam Senator. Voices of those people in Nassau County, in Suffolk County, in Westchester County, in Richmond County, Kings County, Queens County, Manhattan County, and Bronx County will also have to pay this fee. Is it your sense that they also would rather not pay this fee as the residents of the four counties that you've identified in the bill?
I can only speak to the four counties that only have a quarter of a vote. That's not fair.
Will the senator continue to yield?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
Has the senator made an effort to contact, hold any types of public dialogue in Nassau County, Suffolk County, Richmond County, Westchester County, Bronx, Kings, or Queens or Manhattan County, New York County?
Personally, I have not. I've heard from my constituents with regard to only having a quarter of a vote.
Will the senator continue to yield?
Sponsor yields.
Yes.
Is there any legislation that you proposed or that you're aware of that would relieve that burden that you've identified that affects some members of the MTA region that would be satisfied by this bill? Is there legislation that you're aware of that you've sponsored to relieve that burden in the other counties?
That I mentioned, the Orange, Rockland, Putnam, and Dutchess.
Mr. President, if I may repeat, I'm interested in knowing if you're aware, Senator, of legislation that would relieve the same burden that you've identified in the remainder of the MTA service area. We've identified that the fee that you're referring to is paid for by residents of 12 counties. This bill would relieve it in four of those counties, but not in eight of those counties. So I'm asking as a question whether you have either sponsored yourself or you are aware of pending legislation that would relieve that burden in the other eight counties that are affected by this fee.
It would only remove the fees for the four counties that have a quarter of a vote each. The other counties would remain paying the bill.
Would the senator continue to yield?
Sponsor yield?
Yes.
Sponsor
Thank
yield.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, Senator. I appreciate your indulgence on this. What is the correlation between the MTA payroll board, the MTA board's configuration and the relieving of this fee. That the fact that the MTA board has a different allocation based on individual area, is that germane directly to the liability of the individual who lives in any of these 12 counties to pay the fee?
You know, like I said, Senator, only 2%, I'm just talking about Dutchess County, we have the other counties too, that most of them are rural, 2% use it on a weekly basis. So it's a smack in the face to have to pay this fee.
I'll just remind both members to please direct their comments through the chair. Senator Latimer?
Will the senator continue to yield, Mr. President?
Sponsor
yes.
yield? Sponsor yield.
Thank you. Thank you, Senator. The percentage of usage in Suffolk County, Senator, do you have that percentage? You've identified that which is the usage in Dutchess County. Do you have a usage figure of what Suffolk County residents use the MTA system?
No, I do not.
Will the senator continue to yield?
Sponsor yield?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
And Senator, do you have a statistic of how much in Nassau or Westchester or any of the other counties the MTA system is used? You've identified, again, a percentage that's less than half, a lot less than half, in your counties. Have you identified those in any of the other service counties?
No, and I do not, but I can tell you that it's about one-fifth of 1% of the operating expenses or what would be eliminated. The MTA's operating expenses are almost $14 billion to date.
Mr. President, on the bill.
Senator Latimer, on the bill.
Thank you. And thank you, Senator, for your responses to each of the questions. Mr. President, this bill, if the intrinsic value of it is to relieve a burden on taxpayers, then this should be a 12-county bill. The fact that Dutchess County or Orange County or Rockland County is underrepresented on the MTA board, I have personally co-sponsored bills that have been sponsored in both of these houses to correct that situation and to give a full vote for any county that's in this. But regardless of that, there is no direct correlation on this bill in relieving a financial burden to a ratepayer, taxpayer, whether they live in Dutchess County or Suffolk County, whether they live in Orange County or Richmond County, whether they live in Rockland County or Westchester County. If the fee is objectionable, then this bill should reflect relief of that cost for all 12 counties.
Senator Latimer, Senator Martins, are you raising a point of order?
President, would the speaker yield?
As soon as I finish speaking on the bill, I'd be happy to answer questions.
Thank you.
Senator Latimer.
Okay. The bottom line is this. If this bill is to be complete and fair, then it should relieve the burden equally across the 12-county region. Any resident of, any representative of Long Island who votes for this bill is satisfying some of the individuals, but not the individuals in their jurisdiction. And if this is an objectionable fee, as identified by the sponsor and the co-sponsor of this bill, then it should be relieved in all 12 of those counties. I don't think a selective relief of this is appropriate unless there's a dialogue about that and there's a discussion about the use of the MTA system. The percentage use of it clearly is less in some counties than in other counties, but it is also true that amongst the counties that have a higher percentage of use than Dutchess County, there is a gradation of use. A lot more people use this in New York County than do in Westchester County. So with that, I am prepared to vote in the negative, not because I believe that Dutchess, Orange, Rockland and Putnam do not deserve this relief, but I believe that this bill ought to be broad enough to provide relief for my Westchester County residents and for the other residents as well. And with that, I will yield, if you would like, to any question from my friend from Long Island.
Senator Martins?
Thank you, and I thank the senator for yielding. Just a couple of questions, because I think, frankly, Mr. President, through you, the senator and I have worked in the past on measures when he was in the Assembly and I was here and we co-sponsored legislation to repeal many aspects of the MTA payroll tax and precisely elements such as this. Would the senator agree that repealing portions of this tax, even on portions of the MTA region, is something that we should strive for?
Through the Senator President, Biden. I believe that repealing the overall tax at this stage of the game makes perfectly good sense. It was imposed at a moment of crisis. That crisis passed within 2 years of its imposition, and from that point forward, around 2011, I was prepared and co-sponsored bills, I believe, Senator Lanza had a bill along those lines to fully repeal the tax in its entirety. The fact, Mr. President, that we have repealed pieces of it, I presume, are based on some kind of a correlation of money that the state has to compensate the MTA for the amount that would not be paid for, as we have exempted businesses of a certain size and less, as we have exempted libraries, as we have exempted other different entities. So I would say to the senator, I would favor a full repeal. I would vote for that bill were that before us today, and that would be the best case scenario.
Mr. President, through you, if the senator would continue to yield.
I will.
Thank you. You know, having already established that it is probably a travesty in my mind and certainly in many of us in the MTA region that are still required to pay these fees long after they were first imposed, isn't this a good step in the direction? If we understand that this is a bad fee, it shouldn't have been done when it was done, and certainly the time has come to this point where it should have been repealed, and I think there's consensus here where that is true, at least for many of us. I don't know if all of us. Isn't it true then that any step that takes that in that right direction that we should support?
Through the President, I think that this bill could very easily be amended as it is under the current sponsorship to be broadened and include all 12 counties. And that bill I would be glad to vote for, and I would think the constituents who we represent in Long Island, on Staten Island, and in the other counties that are not included in this bill would be happy to see that pass. I think we both know that this bill faces a very difficult future in the other House. And so if what we're trying to do tonight is to make a statement about what's right for the people of Dutchess County and Putnam County and Orange County, we should broaden that statement. And the right thing to do would be to make a statement that would be all-inclusive. And certainly in the majority side, there's an ability to modify the bill. And I would be happy to support a more broad-based bill that would include all of the counties.
Mr. President, through you, I thank the senator for having yielded the time, and would just conclude with the statement that, yes, I would like to vote on a bill that includes all of our respective counties. I would love to vote on a bill that repealed this tax for all, including municipalities, including taxpayers, including large taxpayers, inside and outside New York City, in the suburbs. I think that would be fantastic. And I hope that we have the opportunity to do that, whether this year or next year, where we can reach consensus and do that. And I would hope that the great senator from Westchester can work with the great senators from Long Island, and we can work together towards that. But I will vote in favor of repealing this tax and repealing this fee wherever it happens to be proposed. And hopefully next year it's proposed for Suffolk County and for Nassau County and for Queens County and for the Bronx and for Staten Island and for Manhattan. And yes, we can get this done for Westchester as well. I hope we have the opportunity to vote for those repeals as a House, in this House and in the other House, and we can actually make a statement that we're pulling back all of the taxes that were imposed on our taxpayers. But this is a step in the right direction. It's a positive step. And yes, if it is a one House, then let's make that statement together and make that statement in preparation for the opportunity to do a broader bill next year and send a message on both sides of the aisle, in both houses, that it's time that we repeal these fees once and for all. So I will be voting yes, and I thank Senator Serino for having put this bill forward. And yes, I'd like to have seen a much broader bill, but it's a step in the right direction. Let's be positive about this. Let's support this in the hopes that we can get a broader bill next year. Thank you, Mr. President.
Senator Martins was on the bill. Senator LaValle.
Thank you, Senator Martins, for pointing out some good things that you just said, and I want to kind of come on top of what you just said. I think the other side has heard over and over again that they created a terrible, terrible tax. So each one of us, and it's a shame that we're not coordinated, but I don't know how many members in the 12 county region have bills to repeal the whole thing, a part of the thing. I have bills to do that, and other members also. So it's a shame that we're not coordinated to do this in a way to eliminate it from the community colleges, I think we did the hospitals, and on and on and on. We certainly did it for our school districts. So I'm going to support the bill because it is another member taking a piece out of what is an evil, something that should not stand. And I hope we can build forward for those of us who are here in the next session to just get rid of this tax, that it is onerous, evil, bad, and I am going to vote in the affirmative.
Seeing no other member wishing to be heard, the debate is now closed.